وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، we came to visit our brothers and sisters in Islam who are laying here. We are at the section of the young brothers and sisters. Some of them live 25 minutes in this life, and they have passed through death. كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. They have passed through death, but me and you remain, and we don't even know when it will come. We don't know when our time will expire. We don't know. We think we can run away. We think it's not me. We think it's not you. Everybody thinks it's not for them. Their time is not gonna come now. They have to be 70 years or 80 years. Even if you ask the 80-year-old, he will still insist, not yet. Another 20 more years. But the reality is, we don't even know when time will come. قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that death that you're trying to flee from, it will meet you. You think you're running away from death, but you're running towards death. Every single breath, every single day that passes, closer to this destination, this place, that you will be all alone. Just before these people, these brothers and sisters passed away, or before they died, they were with their loved ones. These young ones, they were in the arms of their mothers and fathers. The old ones, they were with their husbands or wives, holding hands before life departed. But as life departed, they were just covered in sheet and left. Single cloth, that's it. And then they were left. And then they were brought here. Subhanallah. Look at the difference. You are standing here. You came here today. No one brought you. But one day, you will be brought here. And you will be left alone. You will be left all alone. Wallahi, none of us can stay an empty house, dark, empty house, live alone in 4 meters or 2 meters. Wallahi, we cannot stay here. And here, you don't need wealth. You don't need children. يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. The day will come when mal, wealth, and children won't be any help to you. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except that who comes with a pure heart. What is that pure heart? Fear in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear in Allah means obeying Him. Obeying His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Obeying what they command. Wallahi, if you disobey, this is your place. If you obey, this is your place. And the consequence here is severe. We live in this world, on top of the earth. We live for 50, 60, 70 years. If you look certain brothers here, you will find they were here long, long ago, subhanAllah. Think about those who died at the time of Nabiullah Nuh. Think about those who passed away at the time of Musa alayhi salam. Think about our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Think about the Sahaba. Each one of them is staying in the grave over 1,000 years. Allahu Akbar. Life in here is longer. But what have you prepared? Obedience or disobedience? What have you prepared for this life? What have you prepared here? Here There will be three questions. Just three questions. One of you might think, only three? MashaAllah, it's very easy. But wallahi, no. Wallahi, it's not easy. Except that whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for. If Allah does not make you firm in here, you will be punished for the rest of your life in this here. The life here is called al-barzakh. Al-barzakh. Hatta idha jaa ahaduhum al-maut. Until death comes to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. Hatta idha jaa ahaduhum al-maut. Qala rabbi irji'un. Oh Allah, give me respite. Give me time. Time for what? What they want. What do you want? Time to do business? No. Time to mess about? No. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ. I want to do good deed that would help me here. When the person dies, three things will follow him. Three things. Number one, is his deed, whether it's good or bad, his obedience or disobedience. Number two is his wealth. And number three is his loved ones. But guess what? Two will return, one will remain. Your wealth, people will drive your car that day. The car that you love, someone else will drive to follow your janazah, to bring you here. And then that car will return and someone else will make use of it. So is your bank accounts, your credit cards, your debit cards means nothing in here. It means nothing. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Then your loved ones, your mother, your father, your husband, the one who loves you, who is sleeping side to side with you, that day will not remain with you. He will not say, oh, she's my wife, she's my mom, she's my daughter, let me remain with her, let me remain with him, even for 1 hour. Wallahi, no one will remain with us. The only thing that will remain is your amal, your deed. So what have you prepared for this day? The question here will be asked by Munkar and Nakir. Most of us, when we were called for interview by Home Office, you are shaking, you worried, you have court hearing tomorrow, you worried. The police stops you, you worried. But think here, these are angels, someone, some creatures that you never ever witnessed in your life. First time ever, they will make you sit and ask you three questions. Man Rabbuk, who's your Lord? You will only know who's your Lord if you knew him, if you obeyed him in this world. And guess what? It's him who controls the hearts. So if your heart was drifting away from him in your lifetime, Allah will not make you firm to answer that question. I don't know. وَمَا دِينُكُ. What is your religion? What is your way of life? No, I was so westernized. I used to follow the western lifestyle. I used to act like the disbelievers. I have nothing to do with Islam. But my name was Aisha. My name was Ahmed. My name was Abdullah. Do you think your name will help you? Wrong. Name does not help here. Deed helps. Not names. Deeds. If you were so westernized, your way of life, there is western way of life. You were a secular, you were not a Muslim. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. You lost the second question. Lost. The third. Who is your prophet? Who was your role model? Well, my role model was the singers. Rappers, that's what I used to follow. Those whom I loved was those women who were singing, dancing. Men who were singing, dancing. These are the people, footballers. David Beckham was my role model. This is what you're gonna answer. And then you have lost all the three questions. Who is your role model? You have to answer it today, because you have today. You have this chance. You don't have tomorrow. No one has tomorrow. No one has tomorrow. Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah, he has divided the world into three. 3 days, he said, the whole world that you're playing about is just 3 days. Day one is yesterday. Yesterday is gone. Whether you've done good or evil, it has gone. And it will never return except Yawm al-Qiyamah, to be for you or against you. And he said, tomorrow never exists until you reach tomorrow. We don't have tomorrow. Do you think we have tomorrow? Most of us think we have tomorrow. We have guarantees. Who gave you guarantee? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody has guarantee. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, all you who believe, ittaqullah, fear Allah, obey Allah, be obedient to Him, follow His rules, al-Islam, follow His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ittaqullah, waltanzur, nafsum ma qaddamat lighad, let one look what he has put forward for himself or herself here. What have you put forward here? This life that is longer than life on earth. Hayatul Barzakh is another type of life. Don't be deceived by the Western mentality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, زَعَمَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَن لَّن يُبْعَثُوا. Those who disbelieve, they say that we won't be resurrected after we were dead. Look at the tree. Look at this tree. After a few months from now, it will have leaves. See, it's coming now. Subhanallah. Who gave these leaves back? Life back to this tree? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the one who would give you life here. Life here is totally different. First, you were in the womb of your mother. You lived underwater. Now, if somebody puts you underwater for 5 minutes, you're dead. That was different life. One stage, mother's womb, and then from mother's womb to the earth's womb, tomb, that is grave. So you will be in here. Only Allah knows how long. Only Allah knows how long. Another womb, another type of life, different to our ones. Not walking, not talking, not moving, but yet feeling. When we say salam to them, they know. They can hear us, but they cannot reply. They cannot do anything, because Allah has removed that ability. Their life is totally different. So stage one, minha khalaqnakum. Allah says, we've created you from dust, from mud. Allah created us from this. وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ. We will return you to it. This stage. You will be like this. وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ. And we will bring you back from this. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Now is another stage. You see, if you got the questions wrong here, a door, a window of hellfire will be opened to you. And an ugly beam will be left for you. And you will be asking, scared of this ugly thing, who are you? Why are you here? He will say, don't be afraid. I'm just your deeds, your evil deeds that you used to commit. Why you don't want me around now? I'm with you here. You like it or you don't like it. Subhanallah. And agony until Yawm al-Qiyamah. If you got things right here, there will be a beautiful being that will be with you. The Quran that you used to recite, the sadaqah that you used to give, the good deeds that you used to do will be with you here. And you look at this being, you just don't feel lonely at all. You say, who are you? Who are you? You say, I'm your good deeds. I am with you, and the angels will calm you also. They will tell you, لَا تَحْزَنْ لَا تَحْزَنْ لَا تَخَفْ Don't be afraid. We are with you. We are with you, and actually we're waiting for you as you come out from your grave to escort you to your Jannah. We are waiting for you. You are a special guest, unlike the other ones, criminals. Criminals, no one is going to escort them. Brothers and sisters, وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ And then, when everybody goes, Allah at the end will command the angel to blow the trumpet. And then everything will be destroyed. فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ Whoever is in the heavens and the earth will die, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is ever living. Allah does not die. Allah, He is al-awwal and He is al-akhir. He is everything. He is the beginning. He is the ending. He does not die. Subhanallah. Then Allah will ask the angels to blow it again. Then everybody will come out. Everybody will come out. And then there is no sun. There is no moon. Everything is dark. Now we have this light. Subhanallah. This light won't be there. The sun will be removed. The moon will be removed. Allah said they will be joined. Subhanallah. They will be dark. No one can see their fingers. Subhanallah. Fear. Everybody is afraid that day. Everybody. Then conversation will take place between the believers and those who disbelieved and those who were hypocrites, who did not follow the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who disobeyed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who plotted against Islam and the Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Hadid, يَوْمَ تَرَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ The day you will see the believers, male and female, يَسْعَى نُورُهُمْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ Their nur, glowing light from their hands and their face due to the wudu that they used to make, due to their obedience. Allah says, يَسْعَى نُورُهُمْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ They will say, يَسْعَى نُورُهُمْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ بُشْرَاكُمُ الْيَوْمِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell them, بُشْرَى Glad tidings for you. Glad tidings. You have won. You have been successful in your exam. Subhanallah. بُشْرَاكُمُ الْيَوْمَ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ Bushra of Jannah will be given to them as they come out. As they come out, subhanallah. Jannah is for you. بشراكم اليوم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها They will be therein forever. Not 60 years, not 70 years, not 1,000 years. No, forever. سبحان الله. بشراكم اليوم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ذلك هو الفوز العظيم. And Allah says, that is the greatest success. Greatest success is to enter Jannah. Wallah, it's not to win lottery or gain money. That's not greatest success. You want success? Get Jannah. That's what it is. Then what happens? That's the believers. And then the hypocrites will speak. The hypocrites, what are they going to say? يَوْمَ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ The hypocrites, male and female, they will say, لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا They will speak to the believers. When everybody comes out, there is all darkness. But the believers, they have light, guiding them to the sirat, the path. They will say, دُرُونَا نَقْتَبِسْ مِنْ نُورِكُمْ Look at us. Turn to us so we can see the way. Because they can't see anything. It's so dark. The believers can see the way. They can see the Sirat al-Mustaqim that they used to ask every day in Salah. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. And they have acted upon it. And Allah gives them that day the light to proceed. Subhanallah. And then what will happen? ذرونا نقتبس من نوركم. قيل ارجعوا وراءكم فالتمسوا نورا. They will be mocked. And Allah, the angels will tell them, go back and find your light in dunya. Can anyone come back to dunya? This world, no one. They will be mocked. Go back and find your light. You had the chance, but you wasted it. Then what they say? Then there will be a sur. There will be a barrier between them. They will be divided. The mu'mineen will go through. And on that barrier, on the side of the believers, it will be coolness and mercy. On the other side, it will be heat and pain. Subhanallah. Agony. Darkness. Yunadunahum. Then they will call to the believers. Now they can't see them at all. There is barrier between them. Yunadunahum. They will shout out. Alam nakum ma'akum. They will say, were we not be with you? We were Muslims like you. Why you leaving us here today? Come back. Take us. Help us. What will they say to them? The believers will answer back. Yunadunahum. Alam nakum ma'akum. Qalu bala. They will say, yes, you were with us. But you have taken your chances. You wasted your chances. You followed your desire. You didn't want to obey Allah and His Messenger. Not only that, you were actually rejoicing. Any harm that touches us, whenever believers have harm touched them, the hypocrites will be happy. They side with the disbelievers always. A'udhu billah. May Allah protect us from that.
Ameen.
Yunadunahum alam nakum ma'akum. Qalu bala, walakinnakum fatantum anfusakum. Watarabbastum. Wartabtum. And you had doubts in your heart. You didn't believe you will come out. You didn't believe there is accountability. Because if you believe, you would have acted upon the commands of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You were just lip serving. So you get what you deserve today. Yunadunakum alam nakum ma'akum. Qalu bala. Walakinnakum fatantum anfusakum watarabbastum wartabtum. Wagharratkum al-amani. You were deceived by your, you know, shaitan was telling you, Allah is Ghafoor al-Rahim, last minute you will do, you know, last minute you go to Hajj and you clear all your debts, don't worry. But no, time has catch up with you, hatta jaa amrullah, until amrullah come, until death came to you, now you are crying about, now you want to go back, too late. Then it will be said to them, فَالْيَوْمَ لَا يُؤْخَذُ مِنْكُمْ فِدْيَةٌ وَلَا مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. This day, ransom will not be accepted from you. You and those who used to follow. You want to act it like Western? You want to follow them? Let them help you. You and them, today, you have no ransom. No one can save you today. Subhanallah. You want to pay sadaqah today? Too late. You want to pray today? It's too late. No deeds accepted this day. Yunadunahum alam nakum ma'akum qalu bala wa rab al-yawm a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. The verse I was reading at the end was Allah will not accept any ransom from them. And then ma'wahum jahannam, their abode is hellfire. Now the last scenario, after everybody came out and people are just on the sirat, the believers pass the sirat to the other end and accountability starts, and then فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. A group will be in Jannah and the other group will be in hellfire. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرًا. Those who disbelieve in groups, they will be led by the angels where? To Jahannam, hellfire. And then the angels will ask them, أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ رَبِّكُمْ وَيُنذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. Didn't messengers come to you? There was no warnings? No one told you about this day? They will say, yes. Yes, we were told. But we didn't pay attention to this. Too late. Too late. Then you'll be told, خِيلَ دُخُلُوا أَبْوَابَ جَهَنَّمْ. Enter into the gates of hellfire. أَبْوَابَ جَهَنَّمْ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. The bad news is, enter therein forever. Subhanallah. But guess the other side. There is another side to this story. And a beautiful one. It comes after. After this agony, you hear the beautiful side to it. But you have to check, which group do you belong to? وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. And those who were pious, righteous, they will be taken in groups by the angels. Subhanallah. On red carpet, they will be taken by the angels, and they will be told by the gates of Jannah, angels will wait for them, unlike hellfire, no one was waiting for them. They were told, enter, a prisoner, that's how you treat prisoner, isn't it? Enter, no one is coming with you, no one, no angel is inside. Who's gonna wait for you inside? Hellfire, no one, go in there. But the other side, waiting angels, what are they saying? Standing in rows, Salamun alaykum tibtum, Salamun alaykum. They will say, peace be upon you, tibtum, you were good, you were successful, tibtum, fadukhuluha khalidin, enter into Jannah, khalidin, staying forever in this place. Allahu Akbar. May Allah give us Jannah.
Ameen.
Wallahi, it needs deeds. It does not need lip serving. الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده. They will thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believers, in difficult and in good times. They always say, الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الذي أذهب عنا الحزن. In another verse, they will say, الحمد لله, who removed sadness from our hearts. We were sad in the world. We were oppressed. We were called names for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We were patient on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And today we paid. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. They will forget all their feelings, all the bad feelings, all the oppression that took place. They will forget and they will rejoice. And in there, subhanallah, life is so different. Everybody's young. No one is old in Jannah. No defecation, no urination, no illness, no fatigue, no, you know, shortcomings, no pain, no stress. Imagine, in this world, if you are given everything that you like, if they ask you to sit and relax, people will serve you. Wallahi, you will get depressed and you will have problems. You have to be busy in this world. But in Jannah, it's unlike, totally different. It's a place of relaxation, place of rejoicing. It's not a place of working. Here is Darul Amal. Here is place of working. But people want to relax here. People want to relax. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he gave a comparison between this dunya and akhirah. He said it's like putting your finger in the ocean and bringing it out. How much water will you bring with that finger from the ocean? None. Nothing. So dunya, comparing to this world, to akhirah, it's like one drop to the ocean. So akhirah is the ocean, but we are fools. We like that drop of water. We want to stick to the drop of water. We want to stick to the dead donkey when we have, you know, gold around. Subhanallah. Treasure. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam once was passing by the market and there was a dead donkey there. And he asked the Sahaba, who wants to buy this donkey with one dinar? One dinar. He said, Ya Rasulullah, we don't even want it for free. Leave alone one dinar. Subhanallah. He said, Wallahi, dunya is less worthy than that donkey. Subhanallah. This dunya that you love too much, you think you want to stay forever. You would do wrongdoings. You would disobey Allah for. Subhanallah. It doesn't mean anything in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, what group are you in? Fariqun fil jannah wa fariqun fil sa'ir. There are only two groups in this world. Hizbullah wa hizbul shaytan. Hizbullah, those who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The party of Allah and the party of shaytan. Are you follower of shaytan or follower of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger? What are you? If you say, I'm a follower of Allah and his messenger, where is your action? Why you don't obey? When you are told, do this, why you are disobeying? Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى. All my ummah will enter Jannah except those who refuse. Sahaba were amazed. They say, how can some refuse Jannah? Who's gonna refuse Jannah? who is gonna refuse everlasting life to this life? And he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man ata'ani, whoever obeys me, enters Jannah. Wa man asani faqad aba, and whoever disobeys, goes against me, he will enter hellfire. He doesn't want to enter Jannah. Do you want to enter Jannah? Where is your obedience? When you are told, ittaqillah, ittaqullah, stop sinning, stop doing wrongdoings, stop smoking, stop doing taking drugs, stop harassing people, stop dealing with haram, stop, you know, walking half naked. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Ya wallahi al-azim, this place awaits. Prepare for this. Listen, you have not much time. Don't be deceived by this deceiver, chief deceiver, shaitan, like how he deceived our father and mother. Ummuna Hawa, Hawa and Adam, they were in Jannah, he deceived them. He told them, you're gonna leave, you want to have everlasting life? Yeah? Disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what they did. And that's why today we are children who are born in prison. You think you are free? Subhanallah. We were born in prison, subhanallah. This world is prison of the believer. Prison. Adam was in Jannah with his wife. When shaitan deceived them, they were taken out from Jannah. Allah brought them to this world, this universe, this earth. Why? For punishment. To pay for what they have done, even though they have repented. But that was the rule. Yeah. So are you happy with the prison? Subhanallah. We happy with prison nowadays. Yeah? You want to be in prison forever? No, you belong to Jannah. You belong to Jannah. You don't belong here. So brothers and sisters, wake up. Wake up before the wake-up call comes to you. Wake up before the wake-up call comes to you. Before angel of death comes to you, wake up. And don't let shaitan deceive you by telling you, Allah is Ghafoorun Rahim. You tell them whenever you tell, Ya Akhi, Taqillah, my brother, my sister, fear Allah. They say, Allah is Ghafoorun Rahim. Allah is most forgiving. But Allah says, Wa inni laghaffarun liman tab. Allah is only, He forgives whom? Liman tab, the one who repents. Liman tab wa amana wa amila amalan salihan, the one who has righteous deeds. After making tawbah, he repents. He fully repents. He does good deeds. That's what you need. Don't be deceived. You haven't got much time, wallahi. You haven't got much time. Don't be deceived. Don't surrender when you grow old, when you are weak, when you can't walk. Don't surrender when the angel of death comes. Surrender today. Be a Muslim today. A Muslim is the one who surrenders, submits to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah commands something and His Rasul, they can't take it serious. Please, sisters, 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 more than anyone, you are important. You have a role. You, the one who would raise the generation to come, the young ones, you will be mothers, but you have to be good mothers. You have to teach your children about their Lord. So if you are not practicing, if you're not taking serious, if you are imitating the disbelievers, what kind of children will you raise? You will make yourself loser in here, and your children, not only yourself. So are the brothers. Everybody is wallahi mas'ul. Kullukum ra'in wa kullukum mas'ulun an ra'iyati. Each one of us is responsible. Let us wake up, the young ones, the old ones. Let us remind one another. Death, the crusher, the one that destroys. Lust, lust. We live in lust, lust, lust. Always we want to think about that. Business, money, this, woman, children. Everybody thinks, mashallah, that's it, life. No, no, no. You have responsibility, fulfill it. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وسائر المسلمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. اللهم وفقنا إلى ما فيه الخير والرشاد. اللهم آتي نفوسنا تقواها وزكيها فأنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا وعلى طاعتك عنا ومن شرار خلقك سلمنا. اللهم اهدنا ووفقنا إلى طريقك المستقيم. اللهم ارحمنا إذا كفنونا. اللهم ارحمنا اذا كفنونا
آمين.
اللهم ارحمنا اذا كفنونا
آمين.
اللهم ارحمنا اذا غسلونا
آمين.
اللهم ارحمنا اذا غسلونا
آمين.
اللهم ارحمنا اذا غسلونا
آمين.
اللهم ارحمنا اذا جاءنا منكر والنكير
آمين.
اللهم ارحمنا اذا جاءنا منكر والنكير
آمين.
اللهم ارحمنا فانك بنا راحم لا تعذبنا فانك علينا قادر
آمين.
اللهم انس وحشتنا في قبورنا
آمين.
اللهم انس وحشتنا في قبورنا
آمين.
اللهم انس وحدتنا في قبورنا
آمين.
اللهم انس وحدتنا في قبورنا
آمين.
اللهم لا تكلنا الى انفسنا طرفة عين
آمين.
اللهم لا تكلنا الى انفسنا طرفة عين
آمين.
ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اجمعين.